ओके इट्स ओके जैनम, लेट्स कंटिन्यू। द क्वेश्चन 10 सेज अ शॉपकीपर सेल्स हिज गुड्स एट 80% ऑफ द कॉस्ट प्राइस। सो Let the cost price be 100. He is selling the goods at 80% of the cost price. That means the selling price will be 80% of the cost price. So the selling price will be 100. Now see, the selling price will be 80. That means cost price is 100, selling price is 80. There is a loss here. Okay, there is a loss. So what is the loss? CP minus SP. That is 100 minus 80, 20 rupees is the loss. 20 rupees, and we have to find the percentage. So loss upon CP into 100. So what is the loss? 20 rupees. What is the CP? CP is here, 100 into 100. This is our final answer. Copy it. Let's do the next sum. Question number 11. Now, see, in this question, they've told the cost price of the article is 90% of its selling price. So, cost price of article is 90% of selling price. I had told you in the previous class that whenever they give a statement like this, now, which one should be 100? Should we take the CP 100 or should I take the SP 100? I had given you the trick. I had explained you. Yes, whichever comes second in the statement, that will be taken as 100. So CP of the article is 90% of SP. So what I'll do, I'll take let SP be 100. Okay, so the CP will be 90% of SP. 90% of SP. And what is the value of SP? The value of SP is 100. So CP is 90. Now cost price is 90, selling price is 100. That means selling price is more than cost price. So there is a profit here. Okay. So let's write the profit. That is 100 minus 90, 10. Profit is 10, 10 rupees profit. Now profit percent. The formula is profit upon CP into 100. Okay. So what is the profit? Profit is 10 rupees. So 10 upon CP. CP is 90. Don't take it 100, okay? CP is 90, see, here. Into 100. So you will get the answer as 100 upon 9. Do it in, make it mixed fraction. This will be your final answer. Next. Read the next question. Cost price of the article is 30% less than the selling price. 30% less than the selling price. So we will take, let the selling price be 100. Let the selling price be 100. So cost price is 30% less than selling price. Now how to do that? 30% less than selling price. So first I will find 30% of selling price and then I will subtract it. 30% less hai, theek hai? Less likha hua aaya hai, matlab minus karna hai. Okay, so first I'll find 30% of selling price. 30% of selling price means 30% of 100. That is 30. Okay. How much is less? 30 less. That means your cost price is selling price minus 30. That is 70. Understood? They are saying the cost price is 30% less. Okay. So So first, what is 30%? 30% is 30 rupees. Then you will decrease that 30 rupees from your selling price. So your cost price now is 70. See, it is 30% less than the selling price. Cost price is 30% less than the selling price. This is the selling price. Find the profit or the loss as percent. So now see, cost price is 70, selling price is 100. That means it is profit. Okay, let's calculate the profit. Profit is SP minus CP, that is 100 minus 70. Profit is 30. And again, same formula. Profit percent is profit upon CP into 100. Okay, what is the profit? Profit is 30 rupees. What is the CP? CP is here. Here is the CP, 70. So upon 70 into 100. Calculate this. What is the answer in mixed fraction? It will be 42, 6 upon 7 percentage. You have to divide it. You have to divide it properly. See, you will divide it like this. 307. So 7, 4 is a 28, 20, 7, 2 is a 14. So 6 will remain. That means this 42 will come here on the side, and this remainder becomes the numerator. Okay. So this 6 came here and upon 7. Okay. Just copy this one. Done. Next question, number 13. I'll erase this. Now, this is a little lengthy question, so pay full attention. A shopkeeper bought 300 eggs at 80 paise each. So what is the cost of one egg? Cost of one egg is 80 paise. 80 paise means 0.80 rupees. Cost of one egg is 80 paise. Okay, and he bought 300 eggs. He bought 300 eggs. So CP of all eggs. How much did he pay to buy all those eggs? So CP of all eggs will be 300, that is the number of eggs, into cost of one egg. Okay, that is 0.8. Now tell me the answer for this. multiply this, you can directly remove the point and cancel 1 0 here. So it will be 30 into 8. 30 into 8. That is rupees 240. Yes, very good. Only a few students are sending me answers. Why not all? Everybody do the calculation and keep sending me answers. So cost price of 300 eggs. Cost price of all eggs means this all eggs means this is 300 eggs. Okay, is 240 rupees. Now, what happens is 30 eggs were broken in transit. Transit means transport. While transport, 30 eggs were broken. Okay, 30 eggs broken. So how many eggs are remaining? Number of eggs remaining is 300 minus 30, that is 270 eggs are remaining now. Okay, so now he has 270 eggs to sell in the market. He has to sell 270 eggs. Now let's read further. 300 eggs were broken in transit and then he sold the remaining eggs at 1 rupee each. Matlab isne 270 eggs 1 rupee mein ek egg becha. Okay, selling price of one egg is 1 rupee. Selling price of one egg is 1 rupee. That means selling price of all eggs means he sold 270 eggs. Okay, so selling price of 270 eggs will be 270 into 1, that is 270 rupees. Correct. So he, in all, what happened is he bought the eggs at rupees 240, okay, and he sold the eggs at rupees 270. Okay, ye 30 eggs toot gaye, uska kuch nahi kar sakte. This, that is lost, that is gone. Okay, so 270 ka usne kharcha kiya, 240 ka kharcha kiya. Okay, and 270 uske haath mein aaya, means there is a profit here. Okay, so the profit is SP minus CP, that is 270 minus 240, that is 30. So there is a profit of 30 rupees here. Profit of 30 rupees. Okay. So what will be the profit percent? Come on, do it yourself. You can do this very easy. Profit percent is profit upon CP. What is the CP here? CP here. 240 is the CP. Profit upon CP into 100. Yes, very good. You can keep it in mixed fraction or in decimal. Doesn't matter. Just put the percentage sign. Don't forget to put the percentage sign. Yes, very good, Preet, Nivisha, Kreet, Jainam. Yes, correct. Six fours are 6 fives are 2s are 2 fives. So 5 fives are 25 upon 2. 25 upon 2. Your answer will be 12.5%. Or you can write 12 1 upon 2. Put the percentage sign. That is important. This is your answer. All of you copied. Those who have not solved. Okay, so I hope everyone is done. Read the question number 14. Now here also we'll take the CP as 100 because they have not given us the CP. So we will have to assume the CP here. And I will follow the same method which is done in school. Okay. So the question is, the man sold his bicycle for rupees 405. Okay. For rupees 405. So the selling price is 405, losing 1/10 of its cost price. We don't know what the cost price is, but the loss is 1/10 of the cost price. So what we will do here, let the cost price be 100. Okay, so what is the loss? Loss is 1/10 of cost price. You understand 1/10 means like this, 1/10 of cost price. So that is 1 upon 10 into cost price is 100. So what is the loss? Loss is 10 rupees. Okay. Agar CP 100 hai, to loss 10 rupees hai. Okay. Understand. Now, this is not the actual CP. This is what we have assumed. Okay. We have assumed this as the CP 100. Aur us 100 CP pe mujhe loss kya mila? 10 rupees. ओके अब अगर लॉस 10 रुपीज है सीपी 100 है तो लॉस का फॉर्मूला क्या होता है लॉस इज एसपी माइनस सीपी सॉरी लॉस इज सीपी माइनस एसपी ओके सो वी नो फॉर 100 रुपीज द लॉस इज 10 सीपी इज 100 ओके डोंट यूज दिस एसपी दिस इज द एक्चुअल एसपी ना ये तो रियल एसपी है ये वाला ये यूज नहीं करना है मैंने 100 अज्यूम किया है ना तो उस 100 के लिए मैं सॉल्व कर रहा हूँ ठीक है तो मैंने सीपी 100 लिया लॉस 10 मिला तो उसके अकॉर्डिंग व्हाट विल बी द एसपी फॉर दिस 100 रुपीज एसपी क्या होगा सी शिफ्ट दिस एसपी ऑन द लेफ्ट हैंड साइड ये माइनस एसपी विल कम हियर एंड बिकम प्लस एसपी एंड शिफ्ट दिस 10 ऑन द राइट हैंड साइड सो 100 माइनस 10 यू विल गेट द आंसर इज 90 ओके सो हमने क्या अज्यूम किया था सीपी 100 अज्यूम किया लॉस 10 मिला और एसपी 90 मिला ओके नाउ व्हाट डू वी हैव टू फाइंड फर्स्ट वी हैव टू फाइंड द कॉस्ट प्राइस एक्चुअल कॉस्ट प्राइस ठीक है तो हियर आई विल यूज यूनिटरी मेथड वेरी सिंपल यूनिटरी मेथड सी हाउ टू डू इट आई हैव टू फाइंड द कॉस्ट प्राइस द सेलिंग प्राइस इज ऑलरेडी गिवन टू मी द रियल सेलिंग प्राइस इज 405 सो सी हाउ टू डू द यूनिटरी मेथड जस्ट राइट हियर सीपी एसपी Now, we assumed the CP as 100. So, wo jo CP assume kiya 100, us assume wale CP ke liye mujhe SP kya mila? 90 rupees. Correct? Maine 100 assume kiya, to mujhe 90 mila. Okay? To agar mera SP actual mein 405 hai, to for that SP, what is the CP? Understood? Unitary method means what? That 100 jo case aapne assume kiya, you took the CP as 100, you got the SP 90. So what should be the CP that for that CP, the SP should be 405. Yahan pe kya number aana chahiye aisa? Theek hai? You can take it as X also. Okay, and now unitary method, what does unitary method say? First it says you write it like this. Just make sure SP ke niche hi SP aana chahiye. Theek hai? CP ke niche unknown CP. Now you will cross multiply this. क्रॉस मल्टीप्लाई ये यहाँ से ऊपर जाएगा ये यहाँ से ऊपर जाएगा सो यू विल गेट 100 इंटू 405 इक्वल्स 90 इंटू एक्स Now divide this 90 here. Nine ones are, nine fours are, fives are. So 45 into 10. This answer you will get as 450. So that means your actual CP, real CP is 450. Write on the next line. Write this on the next line. Copy this. So CP, first part is done. The CP is 450. Actual CP is 450. SP was 405. Okay. Now I'll erase this. And using this CP and SP, we'll find the second part. So we got the CP as 450. And SP was already given as 405. So, kharida 450 mein, becha 405 mein means there is a loss here. Straight loss. Okay. So, how much is the loss? Loss is CP minus SP. Okay. So, the loss is 450 minus 405. Correct, Kev. Your answer is 45. There is a loss of 45 rupees. Okay. Correct, Preet. So loss is 45 rupees. What will be the loss percent? Loss percent is correct, Dheer. Loss upon CP into 100. That is 45 upon CP is 450. Upon 450 into 100. Correct, Pari. So 45 ones are, 45 tens are. 0, 0 cancel. Your answer is 10%. 10%. Okay, let's do the 15th sum then. It is a similar sum. Only difference is here they have given the profit. In the previous sum, they had given the loss. So a man sold a radio set for rupees 250. So the actual selling price of the radio set is 250. Okay. And gained 1/9 of its cost price. So we don't know the cost price. The CP be 100. Okay. Gain means profit. Gain means profit. Profit is 1/9 of the CP. 1/9 of the CP. So what is 1/9 of CP? 1/9 of 100. Okay. So this is not solvable, so keep it 100 upon 9 only. Keep it like this. This is the profit. Now, what is the formula for profit? Profit is SP minus CP. Okay, profit is 100 upon 9 SP we don't know. Don't use this SP. We cannot use this SP because we have taken the CP as 100, so we'll find the SP for this 100 CP. ये अज्यूम किया है ना हमने, माइनस सी पी इज 100, सो दिस 100 विल कम हियर, वी विल सॉल्व दिस, टेक एलसीएम, 9 इनटू 100 इज 900 प्लस 100, so you will get 1000 upon 9, you will get the SP as 1000 upon 9. We will get the SP as 1000 upon 9. Now I'll erase this because now this SP is not the actual SP. This is the SP for CP 100. Okay. Actual SP is 250. So again, I'll use unitary method here. Okay. So unitary method here. When you take the CP as 100, you got the SP as 1000 upon 9. So what will be the CP for which the SP will be 250? This is how we will do the unitary method here. Okay, same way. Cross multiply this. This 1000 will come here. 1000 upon 9, sorry. Upon 9 also. So this. This 9 will come here and get multiplied. And this 1000 will come in the denominator. X is 225. And what is X? X was nothing but the CP. So my CP is 225. Now you know the CP. You know the SP also. So you can find the second part on your own. That is the profit percent. Do it. Ye SP hai, ye CP hai. Toh pehle profit find karo. Okay. Find the profit and tell me the answer. Profit percent. Tell me the answer directly for the profit percent. The profit is 25 rupees. Find the profit percent. No, Janam. Correct, Deer. No, correct, Janam, correct. Deer, I think you have made a mistake. Yes, correct, Pari. Just make it mixed fraction. No, Kef, wrong. Correct, Preet. Yes, Nivisha also correct. See, you are making small mistake. Here, the profit is 25 rupees. Okay, I'll do it here. So the profit percent is the profit that is 25 rupees upon CP. How much is the CP? 225 rupees. Aapne bas CP ko 250 le liya to galat ho jayega. 250 to SP tha. Okay, so 250 into 100. So 25 ones are, 25 nines are. You will get 100 upon 9. 100 upon 9, okay? And when you solve the mixed fraction, you will get 11 1 upon 9, 11 1 upon 9%. Now, does anyone have the school solvings of the B exercise? What the school taught, the PDF or the screenshots, whatever it is. Does anyone have it? Yes, yes. So just forward me that, those pictures, because I want to stick to the school method only, so that the teacher gives you maximum marks. Now there are a few new formulas in the B exercise which we need to know. So take a fresh page. I'll give you the formulas. Now in this exercise, you will find that they will already give you the profit percent or the loss percent. Question में ही दे देंगे profit percent क्या है, loss percent क्या है, वो find नहीं करना पड़ेगा. तो वो profit percent या loss percent use करके हमें SP या CP find करना पड़ेगा. Okay, SP या CP. So for that, we have formulas. So write down the formula here. This is the formula which connects selling price and cost price. See, formula में क्या क्या है वो important है. Formula में है selling price, formula में है cost price, and formula में है profit percent. So अगर question में profit percent दिया है तो you will use this formula. Okay? और अगर question में loss percent दिया है, okay? Question में अगर loss percent दिया है then you will use this formula. 100 minus loss percent upon 100 into CP. Now, don't just think that this formula will help you to find the SP. This same formula you can use to find CP also. Agar SP diya hua hai question mein, to SP ki value yahan put kar dena, theek hai? Profit percent yahan put karna, and then solve karna, to aapko CP mil jayega. Okay, I'll teach you a shortcut. Only using these two formulas, you can find CP, SP for profit percent, SP for loss percent. You can find CP for profit and for loss. Only using these two formulas. Okay, so very important formulas, note down so that I can start with the exercise. Eight B exercise. Okay, I hope you are done. So let's start with the exercise. Read the first question. There is no cancellation in 8B exercise. Okay. In 8C, last three sums are cancelled. So 8B, full exercise is there. We have to find the selling price. In the first question, we have to find the selling price. If the CP is given as 950 and the profit percent, you see the profit percent is given as 8%. Okay, ab se kitna simple hoga? Formula se use karke solve karna. What is the formula for profit percent? SP is 100 plus profit percent upon 100 into CP. Okay, put the values here. So 100 plus profit percent kya hai 8 plus 8 upon 100 into CP. Sorry, CP is already given na? CP is given as 950. Okay, so 108 upon 100 into 950, 00 cancel, 5 1s are, 9s are, 5 2s are, 2 1s are, 250 fours are. Okay, multiply this 54 into 19. That is your selling price. No, Dheer, there's a mistake. There is a profit, so selling price must be greater than the cost price. Yes, the answer should be yes, Aryo. The answer should be 1026. Correct, Kev, Jainam. Note down this. Copy it. The next question is also same. Only the values are changing. And the formula, in the next question, they have given loss percent. So it doesn't matter. We will just change the formula a little bit. So in the question, instead of profit percent, they have given loss percent. Okay. So there will be a small change here in the formula. CP is given as 1300. Loss percent is 13. So the formula is 100 minus loss percent upon 100. So 100 minus 13 upon 100 into 1300, because CP is 1300. Okay. So 100 minus 13 is 87 upon 100 into 1300. 0, 0 cancel. Multiply this, you will get the SP. The SP will be less than 1300 because there is a loss here. Correct. The answer is 1131. Okay, let's move forward. Question number two. In this question, we have to find the cost price. The selling price is given as 1680. Profit is 12%. Doesn't matter. See, profit is given, selling price, use the same formula. In the place of selling price, write this. Profit percent is 12. Now, just transfer this here. So this 100 will go in the numerator and 1112 will come in the denominator. do the cancellations. You can start with 2. Now I have noticed that 28 and 42 both are divisible by 7. So 7 fours are 7 sixes are 4 ones are 4 fifteens are. So 15 into 100. So you see how using the same formula we can find CP also. Next, sub question 2, same way, try to do it. Only difference is the selling price is given as 1128 and the loss is 6%. So the formula is 100 minus loss. See, profit hoga to plus hoga, loss hoga to minus hoga. That's the only difference. Do this, send me the answer. Now 47 is a prime number, so you have to divide it. So quotient is 12, means 1s are 12s are 12 into 100. Answer is 1200. Correct, Isha. Correct, Nidisha. Pari, correct. Correct, Viram. Next, question number 3. by selling an article for rupees 900. So it means the selling price is 900. A man gains 20%. Gains 20% means profit percent is 20. Okay. Find the cost price and the gain. ठीक है, कॉस्ट प्राइस को हमें ढूंढना आता है, सेलिंग प्राइस दिया है, प्रॉफिट परसेंट दिया है, कॉस्ट प्राइस तो ढूंढ लेंगे. दिस इज समथिंग न्यू, हाउ टू फाइंड द गेन, दैट आल्सो आई विल एक्सप्लेन यू. फर्स्ट लेट्स फाइंड द कॉस्ट प्राइस. सो द फॉर्मूला इज एसपी फॉर प्रॉफिट परसेंट, 100 प्लस प्रॉफिट अपॉन 100 इनटू सीपी. सो what is the answer you are getting? Three hundreds are 3 fours are 2 fives are 2 twos are 2 ones are 2 150. So 150 into 5. Cost price is 750. Now you got the cost price is 750. Okay, selling price is 900, and we have to find the gain also. So gain matlab profit. Gain hota kya hai? SP minus CP. So simple, SP is 900, CP is 750. So what will be the gain? 150. Done. So simple to find the gain. Copy the sum. Yes, let's do the next sum. Question number four. It says, by selling an article for rupees 704. So the selling price here is 704. A person loses 12%. Loses 12% means the lost percent is 12%. So what is the formula? Into CP, this is our formula. Let's put the values here. So SP is 1704. Loss is 12%. Into CP. 88 upon 100 into CP. This 100 will go here. Now see, this 88 is divisible by 11. So try to divide this also by 11. Okay, see 11 8 is a 11, 6 is a 66, 4 will remain. So 11 4 is a 44. 8 ones are 8 8s are. Correct, Kreet. So 8 into 100, your CP will be 800. Now you can easily find the loss also. Loss is CP minus SP. So 800 minus 704. That is 96 rupees. Correct guess. This is the loss. Simple. Correct here. So loss is 96 rupees. Let's do the next question. We'll complete question number 5 today. Question number 5 will be the last question for today. Find the selling price if the cost price is 352. Overheads, they have given you the overheads. What does overhead means? Overhead means if you buy something and you spend some money on repairing or on adding something new to that article. Okay, so that is called as overheads. And profit percent is given as 20. So if you have overheads, you just have to add this overheads to your cost price. Okay, so your cost price will become 352 plus 28. That is 380 rupees. Whenever you have overheads, just add the overheads to the cost price. Okay, so the cost price is 380 rupees. Now you will use this cost price in the sum. Now what do we have to find? We have to find the selling price. So no problem. Selling price is 100 plus profit percent upon 100 into CP. So 100 plus 20 upon 100 into CP is 380. Don't forget to take CP as 380. Now this 00 will cancel. 38 into 12. Multiply this 38 into 12. What is the answer you are getting? Yes, Nivan, correct. 456 will be your SP. Correct, guys. KF. Yes, buddy. Copied others. Next is also same, only instead of profit percent, they have given us loss percent. So the cost price is 576. Overheads is 44 this time. And loss is 16%. Okay. So what will be the SP? 576 plus 44. The CP will be 576 plus 44. What is the answer you are getting here? $620. And this time it is loss. So you will change this minus loss percent. Formula will be SP is 100 minus loss percent upon 100 into CP. Okay. So 100 minus 16, CP is 620. So 84 upon 100 into 620. Zero, zero, cancel. Don't divide this. Do one thing. Directly multiply 84 with 62. Multiply 84 with 62 first. Don't divide by 10. Multiply this 84 with 62. When you multiply, yes, you will get the answer as 5208. When you multiply this, you will get the answer as 5208. Okay. And there is a 10 in the division. So upon 10, 5208 upon 10. So just shift one decimal place. Just shift one decimal point, you will get 520.8. That's it. Zyada easy hai na? Ye to kya hota? If you have cancelled this na, what will happen? This will become 5. Then you have to multiply and divide by 5. Do cheez karni padti. Isse acha hai, denominator mein 10 hai, to usko rehne do. Cover it and just multiply the this 84 and 62. Multiply 84 and 62. Then just shift a point. So your SP is 520.8. That's it for today. I'll end the lecture here. Goodbye to all of you. Take care. No, it's nothing like that, Janvi. I am not in the town, actually. I'm in Rajasthan. So the setup here is different. And I have to talk a little low here. So that is why. Otherwise, I'm okay. My health is good. Bye-bye.